I'm going to attempt to survive 100 days in hardcore Minecraft in only the End Dimension. That's right, the End. You may think this is impossible, but I've added 24 different biomes to make this experience so much cooler. As well as all of the End cities and ores have been customized just for the End. I've set 3 goals for myself: get crystallite armor, defeat the Ender Dragon, and return back to my homeland. Can I do all of that in just 100 days? Watch to the end to find out. And do me a solid, make sure to hit that like button down below and subscribe if you are new to my channel. It helps me out in my journey, and enjoy the video. Day 1 in the End. We literally spawned right next to a fallen airship already, and I was gonna explore that really soon. I turned around and saw this really cool pink tree, and I had to go check it out. I continued playing Minecraft and decided to get myself some wood, and then I noticed an End city right next to where I spawned. I knew that this was gonna take a while to complete, but I had to do it right off the bat. So I continued grabbing wood so I could at least gear up a little bit before I took on this endeavor. Guess what? I crafted a wood pickaxe, the X who won't go away. I went over to this area where there was like this pinkish kind of end stone. This is actually the end equivalent to stone. I made sure to grab all the stone I needed and headed back so I could craft my tools. Once I was able to make all my tools, I went ahead and grabbed some extra wood and some of this flavor stone. That's what I'm calling it from now on. I found this green ore and decided to mine it. It looked a little bit like Ender Pearls, and I found out later that it's called Ender Shard. I couldn't wait to go check out this fallen ship because I was hoping for an elytra right off the bat. Unfortunately, it looks like all the chests were empty and the only thing I was gonna get out of this were books. It was still a cool structure to traverse, as you don't see this in everyday Minecraft. My next goal was very simple. Don't die and beat the End City. That was it. That was my whole plan here. Once I got on top, I noticed that there was actually chorus fruit in this biome. I went ahead and grabbed up as much of this as I possibly could because this could be my literal only food source the entire 100 days. I thought myself the best Minecraft player and it was time to enter the End City. And then I had the best reaction I could possibly ever make up.
No, never mind.
I decided building up would be a better course of action. I didn't think going through the main building was going to get me anywhere but dead. I got to the next layer roof and tried to figure out where I was. I literally had no clue where stuff was in this End City because I had never been to this before. This thing gave me levitation, so I decided to float up a little bit more as I didn't see anything valuable below. I peeked my head in and saw this weird green block. I literally wanted that so bad, but I doubt my stone pickaxe was going to be able to break that. That cage block wanted me to take it so bad. I made my way up a bit and I saw some chests in this room. I broke in and I grabbed what was in this, Unbreaking 3 Iron Pants. Beautiful. Honestly, I can't complain. It's day 1 and I'm at an End City. I got hit by a shulker and decided I needed to eat. I wanted to regen some health and then I forgot that chorus fruit teleports you. I was in the main room with all the other shulkers. I was able to box myself into this room and just wait out the levitation. Chorus fruit literally almost ended my life right there. A second later, I decided to do the same thing and got teleported back into the main room. I am probably the smartest person I know. I blocked back up with the flavor stone, looted the chest, and realized that this was not for me. I tried to find a way out of there, and then a shulker hit me down to 2 HP. I decided to leave the whole thing alone, the exact opposite of what Barry does with the timeline. I ate my magic mushroom and was teleported all the way back down to the ground. I knew that I was gonna have to come up with a better plan for the next time I tried this. I made myself diamond tools and went ahead and geared up with, well, wood. I knew I was gonna need a lot of blocks if I was gonna do this properly. The only way for me to avoid shulkers right now without a shield is to just block them off. I went ahead and towered up so I could get back to the chest area because that was all that was on my mind. Unfortunately, I started taking damage and that meant I had to eat a chorus fruit, so I was all the way back at the bottom. This was gonna take a lot longer than I thought. I decided to tower up a little bit differently this time and see if I could get on this little bridge. No shulkers seemed to notice me yet, but I knew that would change really quickly. I went ahead and towered off to the side here so I could get up as fast as I possibly could. So far, I didn't hear or see any, so I kept going up as sneakily as possible. One roof at a time, as Santa would say. I got back up to that chest with spawner area and decided to break all these spawners. That was my newfound plan. Get rid of these spawners and maybe, just maybe, I would be able to survive all the shulkers. I tried to get this last one, but it had guards and I had to block up yet again. Once I had it broken, I felt actually a little bit safe to start grabbing loot. I found a sharp iron sword and a Prot 3 chest plate, but it had Curse of Binding, so I couldn't put it on. I was really low and I had to eat again, so I was hoping I wouldn't end up where I just ended up. I blocked back off, ate another fruit, and then I teleported all the way back down. I got an achievement though, which I didn't know was a thing. Like I said, this is much harder than I thought, so I went ahead and towered all the way back up, kept getting hit by shulkers, flew all the way past the roof, and had to eat to get back down because I was gonna die. I went to a different island, grabbed a lot more wood for my third attempt. You know what they say, third try's a charm. Alright, this time I was prepared. I was mentally ready to get everything out of this end city, and no one was gonna stop me. I towered my way back up and was ready to steal this loot. Now that I think about it, I'm actually kind of the bad guy in this situation. Oh well. I was able to sneak around the back and check what was in this chest. I actually had a diamond helmet now, which was gonna help me a lot. Every little bit of armor helps at this point because I'm fighting things that can't really kill me unless there's a lot of them and I need armor and you know what? You know how to play the game. I pillared up to the very top of this like very skinny tower and I noticed some bookshelves. I mined the spawner and noticed that this was all shulker boxes. Now I'm not gonna lie, these are actually really helpful because if I'm gonna have to travel the end for a long time, I'm gonna need a way to store all of these items. I went ahead and did that right away. All these extra items were not really necessary in my inventory, so I stuffed them in the blue shulker. There was one last area I wanted to go to, so I flew over to it with one of the levitating shulker mans. Once I got over, I mined in and realized this was a bigger version of the other area. This had a ton of shulkers and I had to do a lot of loop-de-loops to avoid them. I didn't want to have a levitation here because I don't think I'd be able to kill the shulkers at that point. I was running around hitting these guys left and right trying to avoid as much levitating guys as I possibly could. Honestly, I felt like a football player running around here juking all these little guys. I got two down and there was one to go. I noticed the spawner thing, but it opened up a weird way, but I was still able to get it. I crit out the last guy and started looting. I already knew there was going to be a ton of stuff here since there are 8 chests that I could loot. I went around, started grabbing things, and already got a Prop 4 diamond chest plate. I was really happy about that one. Day 3, I was already full armor, and I had to fill up my next shulker box full of all of these extra things. By the end of looting, I realized I had a ton of stuff. This was a great way to start out this 100 days. Oh yeah, don't forget about this green block. I still wanted that. I went ahead and made a leap of faith. I started mining it, and then boom, I got hit with levitation. For some reason, all of these blocks that I want to break have guards, okay? I don't understand. I went ahead and mined down, broke this glass, built over, and ran in. Grabbed the thing and blocked back up yet again. Then I had the brilliant plan to eat a chorus fruit and teleport all the way back down. And that's how you do a successful heist, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, N-City, for all you've provided, but it's time for me to explore some more. I spent the next couple days running through biomes. A lot of these are really, really cool. I'm so glad there's like 24 different biomes in this whole thing. While I was walking through these biomes, admiring them, guess what I strolled up on? Yep, that's right, a gigantic N-City this time. And this one actually had a blimp, which means Elytra time. Before I went ahead and destroyed this entire N-City and stole all of its goodies, I went ahead and grabbed something special. Yeah, that's right. It's just wood, okay? It's building block. You know what? Just go to the end city. Look at that. I towered all the way up. This time, I have almost full diamond armor, and I'm ready to fight this thing. I went ahead and broke into this window and started grabbing stuff, but I had to break the spawners inside. I went around the sides here for quite some time. I'd break spawners. I'd grab chests. This was probably the easiest way to get all the stuff. I stashed everything from this level and headed up to the next. I mined into the roof to get in this room easily and instantly I was hit with levitation. I forgot there was a spawner in here and I really needed to break this thing. Once I got it, there were like 18 levitating boys just trying to kill me. I was getting hit nonstop, so I had to block up a little bit and this was probably the hardest time I've had. There were just constant guys coming up levitating me. I didn't like it at all. Once the levitation ran out, I figured the only thing I could do was go down and block off the bottom area, so that's exactly what I did. I did my little football strat and ran around hitting this guy multiple different times. Eventually, I got him down and I was able to freely loot this place yet again. I forget how good the loot is in all of these areas. I mean, come on, I'm getting like full end city stuff. Like I know there's iron gear in here, but it's still really good, especially for day 6. I was putting my stuff away and realized I had over a stack of iron, 30 diamonds, and a stack of gold already. I didn't realize end cities gave you so much stuff. This is awesome. On my way out, I kept getting hit by these levitating boys and I had to eat a chorus fruit to get back down to the bottom. But there is still more loot to get, so I went ahead and built back up to the next area. By now, I started to realize what areas had loot and was able to get over there really easily. I did the typical go around the roof and break spawners and grab chests. I grabbed everything from the lower level and went ahead and built up to the top. I accidentally forgot to break the spawner and just started putting down my shulkers for all the loot in here. Somehow a Shulky boy did not spawn while I was grabbing all the loot, but on my way out, I did remember to break the spawner. Not that it mattered anyway. I did my little parkour strats and grabbed that green block. I figured it'd be important at one point. A lot of time passed, but I was ready for this blimp. I'd never been in this airship before, and this was gonna be awesome. This thing looked amazing. Guess what? I towered over to the ship, just like everything else I do. I was taking it really slow because I didn't think it'd be this easy until a Danny Phantom flew out of the sky and decided to attack me. The only way for these to be here meant spawners, so I grabbed the crystal and left. I went downstairs, had to kill a shulker and mine two shulker spawners, but then I was able to start grabbing all the loot and I noticed the elytra on a pillar, but I didn't want to take it quite yet. I grabbed all the stuff from the chest and organized them into my shulkers. I already had like 3 stacks of iron, almost a stack of diamonds, and 2 stacks of gold. I can't believe all the stuff I already have from like 2 end cities. I went ahead and grabbed the ender chest, turned around, admired the elytra, this beautiful thing on this pedestal. And then I grabbed it and realized there was already mending and unbreaking on it. I wouldn't have to add enchants to this. This is amazing. This was probably the best thing out of this whole entire airship. Then I went ahead and made shears and started getting wool because you can definitely sleep in the end. Once I got to the top, I went ahead and put on my elytra and started my first flight. I was so happy to be flying around the end because then I could see all of the biomes from above. I guess, not really afar. I was gonna say afar because I feel like that's like a saying or something. Never mind. I flew past the ice spike star thing and I saw this like amber biome in the background. I went ahead and flew through that, but then I saw this awesome blue mushroom biome. I had to go check it out. This whole area was glowing so cool, so I landed so I could check it out. While I was walking through, I spotted another end city. I wasn't gonna go to detail on the looting, but basically there was another blimp and I was able to get another elytra. Once I was done with that, I started walking through this blue biome and saw this giant mushroom. This one was bigger than all of the others, and I really wanted to settle down here. So I did the only thing anyone in their right mind would obviously do. I cut the entire thing in half. And no, I'm not kidding. I actually spent the next 4 days cutting this whole thing down. My plan was to make a base inside of the mushroom, so I wanted the top to stay intact, and I wanted the base to stay intact, but I wanted my house in the middle. So yeah, this is what it was like cutting the whole thing down. It was really boring, and yeah, that's all that happened. Once I was done gutting the tree, I went ahead and laid down a foundation for my base. I really wanted to do some sort of like Japanese place that was up off the ground, and that's kind of what it ended up looking like. I added some fences and fence gates to the side, but then I realized that this was actually uneven. I somehow mismeasured the entire platform, so I had to fix it before I, you know, broke my brain. Once it was fixed, all the fences started making sense again, and it was so much better. I then found the worst thing about building in this entire biome, and it was this slime. These things spawn constantly. At least if I ever wanted to make some sort of grinder with slime, I would have a ton of it from this biome. I crafted some of my wood into slabs and started making a bridge up to my base. I wanted to have a platform where stairs would go up and then I could walk across this like bridge thing, and I don't know, it was something I had in mind. Let's just say it worked out really well, except for the slimes chasing me the whole time, but I think it looks pretty good. I started working on the actual build itself and started trying to think about how I wanted it to be set up. I definitely wanted to incorporate a lot of things from this biome and a lot of other woods as well, so I had to actually go journey so I could find some woods that I wanted. And that's what I did for the next 3 days. I went searching for new biomes, new woods, and new blocks to use. The blue forest had ended, and I went into like this weird purple and orange geyser place. It was pretty short-lived, and I actually found the lantern place. I don't know what to call this. It's like the red lantern area. I don't know. I'm not the best at naming these places, but I'm gonna call it Red Lantern. I also spotted an end city in the distance and realized I, of course, had to go take that on. But first, I wanted to make sure I grabbed some of this wood just in case I ended up using it. I made my way up on this ice spike and saw my forbidden love, a blimp, or any woman in the world. I put on my elytra and I instantly glided in. This was gonna be a piece of cake. I already know how these places function and exactly where to go. Unfortunately, there were already a couple shulkers down here, so I had to crit them out before I could do anything else. I wanted to break the spawners ASAP, but they actually spawned more, and my previous statement does not hold anymore. I have no idea what I'm doing, and I'm getting destroyed by shulkers. Once I finished up the box boys, I started looting. I actually got some pretty good stuff, including a Prop 4 diamond chestplate and of course, the mending elytra. I actually didn't even stick around to loot the actual end city for some reason. I don't know why I didn't do it, but I just guess I chose not to. I was on the hunt for wood anyway, and the end city wasn't gonna give me any. This biome was huge, but guess what I stumbled upon yet again. Yeah, you guessed it, another blimp. I literally only traveled in this biome for like 2 or 3 days, and I still was able to find 2 blimps. I think I just attracted them at this point. So I did what I do best, break both the spawners, grab the elytra, grab everything from inside, and put it all back in my shulkers, and continue my quest for more wood. While I was flying, I almost died. I got really cocky trying to grab out some wood, and I basically was falling to my doom. Luckily, I had a pearl and was able to just sit on this island. I know I'm new to elytra-ing, but that was so scary. I was just constantly flying into the void at that point. If I didn't have a pearl, I would have lost this hardcore world. Not gonna lie, after that scare, I did kind of hit my recording hotkey and ended the recording. But basically, I'll sum it up. I flew into this purple biome, grabbed some chorus fruit, and grabbed some extra wood. Yeah, that was it, honestly. I didn't do anything much. I mean, it was still the same day when I noticed this, but yeah, that was my bad. I was hoping this purple wood was going to be a really good offset for like the greenish blue wood that we had, and honestly, later it turned out really well. Once I had everything I needed, I began my journey home, which was totally not boring, and I'm definitely not going to skip past it. Days 20 through 27 I spent working on this house. Now, I am not a builder, and I don't exactly always know what I'm doing, but I really wanted to do this freehand. So yeah, I know it took me a lot longer than it probably should for this build, but honestly, I'm not really a builder. So you can't really blame me. I started by envisioning the first layer. I wanted to use this orange as like an underlayer for the kind of purple on top. Most Japanese places I've done in the past have like a lot of slabs and stuff, and I wanted to kind of add 2 different layers to it. Once I had the first roof done, I wanted to get inside and just kind of envision a good area and like how I wanted to lay out the house. I ended up using logs to kind of section out part of the house, and I ended up really liking this later on. I started working on the second level because I did end up wanting this to reach up all the way to the top of this tree, so it ended up being about 3 levels. I basically copied the first design because, you know what, why would I change it? What was the point of that? Okay, I'm just gonna go 1 layer up and copy the layer from below. Simple math, people, come on, don't hurt your heads. Once I finished with the second layer, I went up a bit and started working on the third. We are really close to the top of this mushroom tree thing, and I was really hoping that the roof would reach up to it well. We were really close to the end, and honestly, the roof was getting really close to the mushroom. It did much better than I thought, and I only had to use a little bit of the inside of the mushroom to actually connect it to the roof. There's a reason I'm not showing you the full thing this whole time. It's because I want to do a final reveal, and yeah, that's right now. Here it is, my first base in the end. Now, this is definitely more of a house than like an area to do like a lot of the survival stuff, but I think we can make it work for now. Ha! You thought I was done building. No, not even close. I still hadn't done the interior, and I wanted to make it look pretty nice. I wanted to keep theme with like the Japanese type stuff, and I didn't want to just like put chests everywhere, you know, because I'm very simple, and I would have done that if, you know, I didn't have people to please. Anyway, I made the first floor kind of like a kitchen and dining room area. I don't know exactly why I did that. I'm never gonna have house guests over. I mean, unless some of you guys want to come over, you know. I mean, I went ahead and made a table out of stairs, so I mean, the least you could do is come over, I guess. The second level was strictly for storage. I wanted to have plenty of chests up here just in case I needed to like organize my items, which is something I totally do the entire time. I will never get unorganized. Never, ever. It totally won't happen. I also spent quite a bit of time organizing so that everything wouldn't look horrible. I arranged things into their respective chests? I don't know, whatever word that's actually supposed to be used there. Chests. And I was finally able to empty out all of my shulker boxes, which, trust me, took me a very, very long time. Oh yeah, I also made a library up here, but I don't think I would ever use it for the actual enchanting purposes, because I'm never going to find Lapis, because I'm in the end. You thought I was done with really long, boring, lengthy processes? Ha! You thought. I went fishing because I was sick of eating chorus fruit. And let me tell you something about fishing in the end. It sucks. Literally, the only thing you actually do get is fish. And after 9 days of fishing, I had like a stack and a half of fish. That's it. That's literally all I had. This was the most wasted use for storage on my computer, recording all this stupidness. I'm not gonna lie, I kinda hated everything at this point, so I just AFK'd the cooking of the fish. I watched YouTube or something. I'll admit it. I just AFK'd these 2 days. I don't even care. I hate fishing. I don't know why I did this. As you know, one of my goals is to get to the overworld without killing the dragon. That means I have to go through a certain portal in one of the biomes in the end. Not only do I have to find this portal, but I also have to have the right materials when I do. One of the materials I need requires a certain block from one of the biomes that I haven't found yet. The block is called Ender Shard. Basically, it only spawns in the Crystal Mountains. Now, you haven't seen the Crystal Mountains yet, and neither have I, but, well, okay, technically I have, because I'm, like, the one who's already done all this, but you haven't seen it yet, and the one that you're watching me hasn't seen it yet. Anyway, I had to find this biome, and actually, I kind of found a cave. Let me explain. So basically, I was in this amber biome looking for an amber gem because I actually also need that for the item I'm trying to craft. Basically, they only spawn here, and I kind of dug into a cave. Basically, these gems only spawn here, and I dug into a cave full of them. But I also dug into a cave with the exact block that I needed. So what did I do? I broke so many ender shards that I wouldn't ever need to go back to that biome. Then I decided to explore the cave. There were a lot of amber ores, as well as a few other, and also some flavolite. Oh, my bad. Sorry, flavor stone. I wasn't sure if I was gonna ever make it back here, so I just looted up on everything I possibly could before I headed back. That meant I spent a long time underground exploring these cave systems, but I felt like it was worth it for all the things that I got afterwards. On my travels back home, of course I ran into an end city, and there was one area that was worthy of the looting. I decided to let the shulkers hit me up with their levitation so that I wouldn't have to waste any more blocks because I already had to fly all the way back home. Once I got into the main area, I tried to steal the green block, but again, levitation stopped me from doing so. I'm getting sick of these things actually protecting this block. I just want it for myself, okay, please. Once my levitation ran out, I actually was able to get the green block, and then I used the levitation to float me back up to the previous levels. I did my normal spawn breaking and then grabbed the chests, went up to the very top and started sorting all of the things that I'd gotten. Even to this day, I think the end city loot is so cool to get. I mean, honestly, where else are you gonna find like prop 4 armor just sitting around? After these last couple days of flying around, I was so happy to be home. Honestly, there's nothing scarier than going over the void with an elytra. Even if it is a really cool elytra and you're in an awesome biome, there's still nothing better than just being able to chillax in your base knowing you're not gonna die. That day I laid down all the shulkers I had previously filled from my adventures and started organizing. The hardest part about all of this organization was honestly the armor, because I wanted to make the chest still look decent while I did this. Later, let's just say they're totally still decent, but anyway, I organized all of my stuff into these chests and it took a great bit of time. Like I said early on in this video, I was trying to get a full set of crystallite armor, which is basically the second best armor in this game. One of the items is a crystallite elytra, which means you can combine a chestplate and an elytra into one item. To make the elytra, I needed an infusion pedestal, which I was just able to craft. To make this, I actually needed enchanted membrane, which I didn't have any phantom membrane on me. Without the correct materials, I couldn't use the infusion table. So I had to go venture out for another end city with the blimp and farm some phantoms, which is exactly what I did. The phantoms were already on me from the very beginning, and I was already able to get 3. Which is exactly how much I needed, but I stayed until I could actually get more. Just in case I needed it later, I farmed a few more of these phantoms. I actually got hit off this platform by one of the phantoms and thought I was about to die. Luckily, I only took about half of my health from that fall, and I was absolutely shocked. I killed off the last phantom and made my journey home. 6 phantom membranes later, I was definitely ready to craft this new elytra. Once I got back, I started the infusion process. This was so cool because they added an animation to this with particles. This system of actually getting these items is so much cooler than I've ever seen before. Once I had everything ready, I put the elytra on the pedestal, but nothing happened. I realized the things I put on the platforms were actually facing the wrong way. The amber had to be facing north, and boom. The animation started and everything was coming together. I was gonna have a crystallite elytra. Not gonna lie, this took way longer than I thought to infuse, but boom, there it is. This elytra looks so cool, and this was a chestplate and an elytra combined. I didn't want to use this quite yet without the armor, so I went ahead and put it upstairs in this pink shulker box. I was saving it for later when I had the full set of crystallite armor. And that was next on my mind. To get the full set of Crystallite armor, I would need Terminite. Terminite is like the third strongest armor, or basically what you use to make the strongest armors, which is exactly what that green block was, so it was important. I thought you had to use Thalassium to make an anvil and a hammer to break down the Terminite into its plates, but I was wrong. I actually needed a Terminite hammer and a Terminite anvil to craft the Terminite into its plates. So basically, I spent a day smelting Thalassium for literally nothing. Once I realized what I did, I made a Terminite anvil and a Terminite hammer. But I was unlucky and didn't have enough Terminite, which meant I had to spend the next few days End City hunting. Which, honestly, that's kind of been my favorite part of this whole thing. On my journey for End Cities, I found this awesome floating pink island biome. If I were to do this all over again, I would actually consider making like some rope bridges in between these islands and living here. This would have been an amazing place to live, for sure. After days of flying biome through biome, I finally found the first End City. I made my way up and grabbed the first Terminite block that I had gotten on this journey. This was actually a huge End City, so there was a second Terminite block for me, and I grabbed that instantly. Then I headed into the first roofed area. I wanted to grab all of the End City loot because, you know what, I'm greedy and I want to fill my chests up, okay? Once I had everything from the End City, I went ahead, used the levitating boys and my elytra to get over to the blimp super easily. I grabbed the crystal like normal and then I headed straight down into the basement. I broke both the spawners and one shulker was able to spawn in that time, but that didn't matter because I was fully kitted out now. I did my deed and grabbed everything from the chests, the elytra, and packaged it all up for my next End City journey. The next few days were exactly like this. I would roll up on an End City, grab the Terminite, loot it up, put it in my ender chests or my shulker boxes, and leave. Honestly, it's basically the same footage you've seen before, and this happened numerous times on my journey. Along the way, I think I found four or so End Cities, and I made my way back home. I had all the Terminite I needed, and I just had to find my house again. After four more days of travel, I was finally back home at the end of day 60. Now that I had all the Terminite I needed to make the base set for Crystallite armor, I loudly turned them all into plates and crafted my first set of full Terminite armor. Now it was time to infuse all of this Terminite with all of my Ender Shards and Amber Ore to turn it into Crystallite armor. Every single piece of armor changed from Terminite into Crystallite, and they all looked so cool when they did. Day 61, I was rocking full Crystallite armor, and I even got status buffs. This thing looked absolutely amazing, and I was so excited to put on my elytra chestplate as well. I loved the fact that I had wings on my back with this armor, and I was so excited to use this armor. Without enchants, my actual diamond armor was technically better, but once I had enchants on the Crystallite armor, after I found the overworld, I would be fully set. Now that I have this full Crystallite armor, the next goal was to find the overworld. To do this, I had to find a certain portal, and I wasn't sure if it was going to be complete, so I had to make some runed flavolite. This was the block that the portal was actually made out of, and I made some extra just in case the portal was not finished. To activate the overworld portal, I actually had to infuse an end crystal and turn it into an eternal crystal. This thing actually looked so cool. This was the way I was going to be able to activate the overworld portal and finally leave the end. Once I had everything I needed, I was on the hunt for one of these portals. I didn't know exactly which biome they spawned in or if they spawned in all of them, so I basically just ran around for the next 3 days. Of course, I found an End City on my way, and I looted the whole thing dry. Well, you've already seen this footage, so back to portal finding. While I was hopping around the regular end, I saw something in the distance that could be it. I wasn't positive, and I had to go check this thing out. Once I got there, I realized the entire thing was fully built, and I didn't even need the ruined flavolite. So once I put down all the crystals, the overworld portal opened up in a big roar, and this was epic. It was finally time to leave the End Dimension. I was sad to say goodbye, but I had to go visit the overworld. Here we go. We went through the portal, and of course we're in a cave, because why not? I was actually happy to be in a cave though, because the only two things I really came here for were lapis and gravel, and I found both of them within like 10 seconds of the portal. And then I saw it, my first creeper, the only mob not outside the end, and of course it blew up, but you know what? I needed the gunpowder anyway. I got out of the cave and we were actually in a coral reef, and I had to use my silk touch pickaxe to get some of the coral for my own ponds in the end. Then I decided to grab my own fish for my own ponds, and I named him Merlin. I was actually so excited to have a friend in the end, and I was so happy that I was going to be able to take him back. Now that I had everything I needed from the overworld, I went back into the end and was ready to head straight into the nether. Obviously, I had to travel all the way home first so that I could gear up and put away Merlin, but it was totally worth it, possibly. By day funny number, I was home making a coral reef in one of my little ponds just for Merlin. I honestly think it turned out pretty well and I put Merlin in, but I didn't want to lose him, so I picked him back up. Day 70, it was time to make a nether portal. I was actually really excited to go because I had to trade with piglins. I was gonna need a lot of arrows and I know they traded quite a bit. I grabbed my flint and steel and it was time to head in. Or so I thought. Apparently, nether portals don't work in the end, and I didn't know this, so I had to spend the next couple days traveling all the way back to the overworld. I'm not gonna lie, I'm kinda dumb and I didn't write down where it was, so I kinda only had the general direction, but I was able to find it after a couple days. Once I got there, I went straight ahead and made myself another portal, and it was time to finally go into the nether. I had basically a stack of gold blocks that I wanted to trade with these piglins, and I knew I was gonna spend some time in here, but it was totally worth it. When I got in, I thought it was all soul sand, but it turned out that only a little bit of it was soul sand. It didn't take that long before a lot of piglins were mad at me and I had to shove them in a hole. I was able to get three of them in there and start trading really quickly. I threw down my gold and was already getting some pretty decent stuff. The only thing I truly wanted was fire res potions and some arrows. The only reason I wanted fire res though was because I didn't want to burn alive while I was in hell. I didn't want to use all of my gold on these guys and I had already gotten some really good trades. Day 74, I headed back into the overworld and I actually wanted to check out the surface a little bit more. Once I got out of the water, I realized I was pretty close to land and it wasn't raining anymore, so I was actually excited to check this place out. Within minutes, I already found a village, which hopefully me being here doesn't get all these guys killed. The only reason though I was actually in the overworld was for apples and I had literally no luck. I wanted to have golden apples for the Ender Dragon fight, but I guess I was going without it. Before I left, I went ahead and grabbed a lot of stone. I wanted to be able to use it for armor stands and I guess possibly a block later. I'm kinda dumb and I ran home to end out these days and then I realized I had to turn around. I wanted to go back to the overworld and start mining a little bit as well as go to the nether and grab more levels. And I couldn't do that from my base, but instead I decided to run back. I don't know what I was thinking. After I realized how dumb I was, I went ahead and turned around so I could go grab the levels I actually needed. By day 78, I actually made it all the way back to the portal and was gonna start the thing that I wanted to do in the first place. I went ahead and took my time to actually mine since I hadn't been in the overworld before, and I even found my first vein of diamonds. It definitely wasn't my last though, cause I found quite a bit more. See, look, boom, right there, even more diamonds. Look at that, and right there, even more diamonds, okay? Basically, that's kinda how this mining trip went. Once I felt like I was done mining, I filled up my shulker with everything I felt like was important, and I headed right into the nether so I could get some more levels. The reason I was here in the nether is because I wanted to mine a lot of quartz so I could get past level 30. The reason I wanted to get past level 30 is because I was gonna need a really good bow to defeat the Ender Dragon. The levels that I was at right now was not gonna work, but by the end of my 2-day mining trip, I was able to get to level 34, which was hopefully gonna get me at least a power 4 bow. Once I was done getting all the levels that I needed, I headed right back to my base and started enchanting. You know, it's always a good sight when you get past all the blue mushrooms and are able to see your house after a long night of traveling. While I was over at Merlin's pond, I noticed that there were actually a few jellyfish and some endfish that actually spawned. I placed down my sugarcane in hopes that it would grow so I could actually craft fireworks for the end fight. Now it was time to actually enchant my bow, and right off the rip, I had Unbreaking 3 as an enchant, but I had to risk it and I actually got Power 3. I actually wasn't totally happy with this, so I crafted another bow and it actually had Power 4 Flame. After smelting some items, I was actually back at level 30 and I went ahead and enchanted another bow just in case I got anything awesome. It was actually Flame, but I decided to take it just in case and I got Power 3 again. I decided to combine all of my bows and actually make a Power 5 Flame 1 Unbreaking 3 bow. This was going to be so helpful for the Ender Dragon fight as I was not going to be able to kill them with just my sword. I had a feeling I'd get launched a lot. I realized that the sugarcane farm was actually not going to grow by the time I needed it, so I went ahead and grabbed it anyway and just made it into the paper I needed. I was actually able to get 18 fireworks and I was totally happy with this. I was going to definitely need these guys for the Ender Dragon fight, no doubt. I also wanted to make sure I was fully protected, so I went ahead and put back on my diamond armor set. I know the crystallite would have protected me, but I don't have prop 4 for it yet, and I don't think it was worth risking it. I also went ahead and filled an entire shulker with beds, okay? I was gonna need this if I was gonna blow up this dragon. I was finally prepared, and it was time to head out on my journey to 00 to find this dragon. 00 was actually a lot farther away than I thought, but I finally made it back to where it all started. I went to the edge of the island and I built up all the way to max height. I didn't really want to use all of my fireworks just to get there from this like 1,000 block glide, so building up seemed like the best option. This was it, height limit, we finally made it. It was time to make the longest glide I've done yet. I was so nervous, but I went straight into it. I didn't want to accidentally fly into the void, but here we go. I got the Ender Dragon boss bar and I was able to see the entire end island below me. This place looked absolutely insane. While I was on the elytra, I started popping shots at as many of these towers as I possibly could get. The bow seemed to drag here and there, but I was actually able to get quite a bit of the towers in my first glide. I don't want to cut any of this out, so here it is with some music over it, because I also don't want to commentate over the whole thing, because that would probably be Let's go, we killed the Ender Dragon with a trick shot. Now in this clip, I was actually trying to put out the fire so that the XP didn't burn because I didn't know if it would or not. And I got trapped in bedrock, which means I had to pearl out and I got hit in the portal and now I'm in the village and I didn't even get any of the XP. Which means for the next 5 days, I had to travel all the way back to that dragon just for the EXP. I guess it's my fault for wanting XP. All right, I get it. I gotta spend 5 of my days doing this. All righty. I finally found this pillar once again, and I flew up to it, and then I went ahead and did my glide all the way to the dragon. By day 99, I was able to finally get back and collect my prize, my EXP, and this awesome dragon egg. I can't wait to get back home so I can actually make a cool podium for this. Once I got back, I immediately started work so I can actually make a cool house just for the Ender Dragon egg. It took me a while to actually envision what I really wanted, and it kind of ended up looking more witchery than I wanted, but for now it'll work. I think it does the dragon egg well, and now I can see it from pretty much anywhere. 100 days later, and I was actually able to complete every single challenge I set forth. My house looked great, the armor I had was amazing, and I now finally had a dragon egg all to myself. If you guys did enjoy this video literally at all, please do me a solid and hit that like button down below, as well as subscribe to my channel, because I'm trying to grow while making these 100 days videos and they take so much effort. Thank you for making it this far. Make sure to join my Discord down below and have a great rest of your day. Peace out, everybody.